have a very nice little vacuum engine that's made by Star Power. Comes with a set of Allen wrenches, a bottle for your alcohol, and a little plastic tube. I have no idea what that tube is for. I think it was supposed to go in this bottle, but it doesn't. And then you have the instruction sheet, such as it is. This is a very clean-looking engine. These brackets appear to be laser cut. I say laser cut because I can see just a bit of a burnt edge right here. Nice sharp edges. No, it's not scratched up or beat up or anything. And all the brackets and that seem to be bent cleanly and at 90 degrees. The crankshaft runs on a couple of bearings here and here, little flange bearings. And this actuating shaft for this valve, they run in a set of bearings as well. It has a snappy feel to it, and I say snappy because it pops cleanly, just gives the appearance that it's ready to run. Maintenance-wise, there's not much to do. I would put a little oil right here on this pin for the connecting rod. This piston appears, it's probably made out of carbon or something. It's some black material. We're not going to mess with that. And put a little bit here. There's a couple of little nylon washers that keep this from getting up against these offsets for the crankshaft. And a little bit here and there. And that's it. This one does not want oil in the cylinder. I would use my molybdenum disulfide again if I need anything. We'll wait and see before we go adding anything. This is the alcohol burner. Now on this engine, it has a piece of stainless steel that goes up and down as the valve over this intake exhaust port. And this is a rigid piece of material. It's not a piece of thin shim stock like what was on the other vacuum engines. When this is adjusted properly, this should completely cover that hole. Now it's just there, covers the hole, travels a little further. And you can hear it making that popping sound with that valve. Alcohol burner. This does not have a cotton wick. This is a piece of screen wire that's rolled up. And it's going to wick the alcohol up here through by capillary action. And before we get started, I'll measure how much you can put in there. It's got a vent hole in this cap. And that was too small to get any of my syringes in there. So I drilled that hole out to a number 54. It's not sealed. This cap just pushes down on there. So you don't want to overfill it or you'll have alcohol everywhere. And that's about it. Time to see if it runs. I have the wick shoved down on this to where the top of this wick is right about in the middle of that hole. We're going to start there. This has a nice little clip on it that keeps this alcohol burner from dancing around. I do not expect this to run very long, and I say that because this cylinder is pretty thin. I expect it will heat up fairly fast. It appears you have to put a little alcohol in that wire mesh to get it going. The nice thing about the metal wick, it won't burn up if you run out of fuel like a cotton wick does. I may have that wick a little bit too low. I pulled that wick out quite a bit more. Now it wants to start. You play with the position of that fire to adjust the speed. And the exhaust is going to keep trying to blow that out, it looks like. When I received this, that wick was up there pretty high. I thought it was too high. I'm getting back to about where it was. Apparently it has to be high and get the fire up here because the exhaust keeps trying to blow that out. You play with the position on this, adjust the speed. You can see that fire being drawn in through the port and then the exhaust gas blowing this flame around. The flame is really kind of big. You can't see it real clear. Other than playing with the height of the wick and drilling this vent hole out, I haven't touched anything. This is running just the way it was received, right out of the box. That's about as long as that wanted to run, and this cylinder is very hot. So now we'll just let it cool off, and we can look in here and see how much of the fuel we used. I filled this tank with 4 milliliters or 4 cc's of denatured alcohol. We used about half of that in this short engine run. I did not expect this to run very long, and that's because this cylinder is not very big. When this gets real hot, you lose the effect of the gases cooling on top of the piston, which is what keeps this running. The way this works, the piston comes forward. This valve opens, it exhausts what gas has cooled on top of the piston. And now the connecting rod is starting to travel backwards. The piston is drawing in a fresh batch of fire. And the valve is closed right at this point. And that's pretty much when the connecting rod gets straight back. Hot gases from the flame are trapped between this valve and the piston. And the cool cylinder causes those to cool down. And it drops the pressure on top of the piston just a little bit. Atmospheric pressure out here is greater. It pushes up on the bottom of the piston. It comes along and it exhausts the gases that have cooled off. And then it draws in another batch of hot gas from the fire. And it just keeps doing that until that cooling is no longer effective. And the whole thing is kept running by the flywheel. Nice little engine, not terribly expensive, and it runs right out of the box. At least this one did. That cylinder's still quite hot. Don't forget to oil the moving pieces and put a little bit right here on this rod that goes back and forth in this valve. And that model should last a long time.